गुड इवनिंग टू एवरीबडी, वेलकम टू द टुडे क्लास लाइफ इंश्योरेंस दैट वी आर डीलिंग द मरण इंश्योरेंस देन सम ऑफ द पोर्शन दैट वी कवर्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास दैट इज ऑन सैटरडे बिकॉज संडे इज ए हॉलीडे एंड मंडे आई डिड नॉट टेक द क्लास बिकॉज ऑफ द इंटरनेशनल वुमेन्स डे प्रिपरेशन इज गोइंग ऑन ओवर देन वी विल सी द रेस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट इन द मरण इंश्योरेंस एंड दैट वी आर डीलिंग बेस्ड ऑन द क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड ओवर देयर सो ऑन द क्वेश्चंस वी आर गिविंग द आंसर्स फॉर दैट वन. So this online class is there. It is nothing but a repetition, or we can say revision. So let me say that what I posted on the screen, because I posted some other thing, but I could not see here the same thing. The TE. Let me check it whether it is there or not. Yes, there GE. GE means where is stand for G. Good afternoon. This is and good evening. This is yes, yes. And I'm sure that you could see that the same thing which I posted in the morning also in the group that can you read again what is yes.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
You educate a man.
Yes.
You educate a woman. You educate a generation.
Yes. What did you understand?
If you educate a man, you will educate only that person.
Yeah. But
if you educate a woman, that whole generation will be enlightened by that educated woman.
Yes, that is because the entire system would be changed when you educate a woman. Because in the way of speaking, in the way of dealing the things, in the way of attitude, and everything will be streamlined over there. That's what I want to say. And let us come to the point. Our study is concerned because we are dealing these. Let us see the types of marine policies. What are the type of the marine policies that we'll see it? Then the type of the marine policies go the voyage policy. And a voyage means trip, one trip. When a marine insurance policy embodies the contract to insure the subject matter at and from or from one place to another, the policy is called the voyage policy. Means from the loading place to the unloading place. That is a voyage. That is the reason they say subject matter at and from. And from one place to another, the policy is called the voyage policy. And in a voyage policy, the subject matter is insured for a particular voyage. Means only one way. Voyage, irrespective of the time involved. Either it takes 15 days or 20 days or 1 month, it doesn't matter. But one place loading and another place unloading, up to that policy is set in the voyage policy. In this case, the risk attaches only when the ship starts on the voyage. From the starting point of the loading, from the moving point to the reaching point, up to that extent, that policy, whatever the damage is done in the voyage, that covered on the voyage policy. So this is one of the marine policies, types of the policies. Then the time policy is concerned. It is not dependent on the voyage, and it depends on the time. The 1 week, or 10 days, or 15 days, or 30 days, whatever it is agreed on the terms and condition, and where the goods will be transferred from one place to another place within their specific time. A time policy is an insurance policy embodying a contract in which the subject matter is insured for a definite period of time. That this time, this much would be there. That is clearly given the section 27, clause 1 of the Marine Act. The ship may pursue any course it likes. The policy would cover all the risk from the perils of the sea for the stated period of time. A time policy cannot be for a period of exceeding 1 year. It will be invalid. Then the time policy cannot be for a period of exceeding 1 year. That we can think only 1 year time policy, but it will be invalid if it could go beyond 1 year. But it may contain a continuation clause. That is clearly section 27, clause 2 is given. The continued clause means that if the voyage is not completed within a specified period, the risk shall be covered until the voyage is completed. So the continuous clause also put over there. Suppose a stipulated time the ship will not reach to the particular place, then the continued clause will be continued. And this clause makes the voyage is not completed within a specified period or time, the risk shall be covered until the voyage is completed. Means the goods reach to the destination. Or till the arrival of the ship at the port of a call. Yes, it reaches to that. So up to that extent, we can say the time policy also there. If the time is not specified over there, then the continuous clause will come into the rescue till the ship reaches to a particular destination. The third up is the mixed policy. The mixed insurance policy is a combination of the voyage and time policy. Both are together would be there. Voyage plus time, and that is the mixed policy, and covers the risk during the particular voyage for a specified period of time. A contract for both the voyage and time may be included in the same policy. So we can choose the policy in a such a nature also. Then the fourth one is a valued policy. And what is meant by valued policy? That means a marine insurance policy may be either valued or unvalued. A valued policy is a policy which specifies the agreed value of the subject matter. Suppose the subject matter is valued over there is 1 million. So when you fix it to 1 million, if any damage caused to the subject matter at the time, it is a compensatory amount is only 1 million. So that is such a policy is said to be a valued policy. Insured between the insurer and the insured, and it is specified in the policy itself, that is clearly mentioned in the section 29 plus 2. The value fixed to the policy is as between the insurer and insured. So whenever fixing the value policy, then naturally the both the parties should agree over there. Of course, the value will be made depending upon the worth of it and the size of it and the cost of it, with the voucher also be present over there to fix the value of the subject matter is that much. And a conclusive of the insurable value of the subject intended to be insured, whether loss be total or partial, either the loss may be the total to the subject matter or to the partial or whatever the would be there. Of course, depending upon the quantum of the damage that has happened, that quantum will be taken into consideration for awarding the damages or awarding by the insured. The insured will be indemnified up to that extent the subject matter is damaged. However, unless expressly stated, the value fixed by the policy is not conclusive for the purpose of determining whether there has been a constructive total loss or not. So it is depending upon the party to make it out. See, if anything damage is happened to the subject matter, at that instance the total subject matter becomes useless. At that instance, that total amount which is agreed in the terms and conditions, the value policy will be covered by the insured. I mean, in other sense, that amount will be indemnified by the insurer, in other words. Then the fifth one is open or unvalued policy. Open or unvalued policy. An unvalued marine insurance policy is a policy which does not specify the value of the subject matter insured. So what is the subject matter of the insured will not be made it clear. That is the open value would be there, that is said to be the unvalued policy. Subject to the limit of the sum assured. Of course, there is a sum limitation to be there assured. It leaves the value of the loss to be subsequently ascertained in the manner explained in the policy itself, that is section 30. It means that the method of ascertaining the value of the loss has been agreed upon between the insured and the insurer beforehand in case of unvalued policy. So they come to the method of ascertaining the how much the value of the loss caused to the subject matter agreed upon between the insured and the insurer beforehand in case of an unvalued policy. So they will sit here and they will ascertain so how much between the insured and the insurer, and they decide it how much the unvalued policy at that instance. For the valued policy, okay, what is agreed in the terms and conditions of the bond, it is given the amount, that much amount will be indemnified by the insurer. Then comes the sixth one is the floating policy. And a floating policy is a policy which describes the insurance contract in general terms and leaves the name or names of the ship or ships and other particular to be defined in the subsequent declaration. And the subsequent declaration or declaration may be made by the endorsement of the policy or in other customary manner unless the policy otherwise provides. The declaration must be made in order of the dispatch shipment. So now question comes over there. What is floating? Here floating means fluctuating here. The floating policy is the policy which describes the insurance contract in general terms and leaves the name of the ship and ships as the particulars to be defined in the subsequent declaration. So here the other things will be totally given and it will determine the general whatever the damage is done to the subject matter, that much damage will be given to the insured. So such a policy is said to be the floating policy. In further, unless the policy otherwise provides, suppose specifically mentioned over there, the declaration must be made in order of the dispatch of shipment. They must, in the case of goods, and the comprise of all consignment within the terms of the policy, and the value of the goods and other property must be honestly stated. And any omission or an erroneous declaration may be rectified even after the loss or arrival, provided that the omission declaration was made in good faith. So if there is any other thing is missed over there in good faith that can also be covered, then it can be determined. If the declaration of value is not made until after notice of loss or arrival, the policy generally treated as an unvalid policy. So when it is not determined the, how much the amount would be there of the subject matter, at that instance we can say that it is an unvalid policy as regard the subject matter of that declaration. So such policies are very useful to merchandise who regularly dispatch the goods through the ships. So a person who dispatches the goods or the ships from time to time, then they will make the floating policy. It depends upon what they agreed at the time of the buying the insurance. Then let us see the principle of marine insurance. What is the principle they would use it when they want to use this marine insurance? The first and foremost principle is utmost good faith. Oberrem fide. Yes, the contract of the marine insurance is the contract oberrem fide. That is the contract of the utmost good faith. This is the fundamental principle of the insurance law. There is no difference between the contract of insurance and any other contract, except that in the contract of insurance, there is a requirement of the utmost good faith. That is the General Assurance Society Limited versus Chandu Mul Jain, year 1966, Supreme Court, 1644. It is clearly mentioned that according to Section 19 of the Marine Act, a contract for marine insurance is a contract based upon utmost good faith. And if the utmost good faith be not observed by either the party, the contract may be avoided by the other party. That is under Section 20, the assured must disclose to the insurer before the contract is concluded every material circumstances which is known for the assured, and the assured is deemed to know every circumstances. Under Section 21, it says the agent must disclose to the insurer every material circumstances which is known to him, and an agent to insure is deemed to know every circumstances where the insurance is affected for the assured where an agent. So very important thing is the duty of the disclosure continues to apply even after the conclusion of the contract. So from the beginning to the conclusion of the contract, the disclosure should be continued and it should be applied at any time. So there is oberrem fide. So utmost good faith is one of the first principle in the marine policy. Then the second principle is said to be the principle of insurable interest. So unless until there is no insurable interest should be there on the subject matter, even the insured will not come forward and meet with the insurer. What do you say? Yes?
Sir, one second.
See, why do you make the insurance? Why do you buy the insurance?
For a security purpose, sir. There is no guarantee for the life, no, sir. There may be risky at any time.
Only life?
If it is a life, we will
either living thing or non-living thing, or for life or non-life.
Both, sir.
The subject matter, the both.
Both we can make it.
See, yes, we want to have the interest in protecting the subject matter. Hence, we will insure it. In case the subject matter goes to loss or damage, either in the voyage or in the transit or in the loading unloading, in any manner, at that instance, the insurance company will come to the rescue. So that is the reason we do have the interest in particular subject matter so that we will insure it. Otherwise, there is no interest at all. When it is there or may not be there, it doesn't make any difference. He will not make the insurance. So the principle of insurable interest states that the insured must be in a position to lose the financially if a loss occurs over there because of the untoward incident. In a contract of marine insurance, the insured must be interested in the subject matter insured at the time of the loss. It is the first party who is having the interest to see that The second part is what I say, Balaji will be, but though the he need not interested with the insurance is affected, but what he is more interested is interest in the subject matter. That is the point. Insurable interest. So a contract of marine insurance is deemed to have a wagering contract where the assured has not an insurable interest and the contract is entered into with no expectation of the acquiring such an interest. In a wagering contract, they are least bother about the subject. They bother about the stake money. But here, the insurable interest on the subject matter, that is the second principle. And according to the Marine Insurance Act, every person has an insurable interest who is interested in marine adventure. So, actually, those who go for the marine adventure road, they will definitely know the value of the marine insurance and they will insure the property, that they have the insurable interest. In particular, a person is interested in marine adventure where he stands in any legal or equitable relations to the adventure or to any insurable property at risk therein. Where he feels that the property would be the risk and he wants to protect the property and the insurable interest will be there on the property and see that and he will buy the insurance policy. In consequence of which he may benefit by the safety or due arrival of the insurable property or may be prejudiced by its loss or by damage thereto or by the detention thereof or may incur liability in respect thereof. Unless and until that a person doesn't have an insurable interest and he will not buy the
insurance policy, sir.
Insurance policy. But here we are dealing the marine, hence we could say the marine insurance policy. So now let us see that the following persons are deemed to have insurable interest. Who are the people having deemed to have interest? The owner of the ship has an insurable interest in the ship, definitely. The owner of the ship wants that his ship should be in safe custody, not safe custody, safe should sail in the on the sea water. That is number one. The owner of the cargo, yes, the cargo which is going over there, that he is also having interest that the cargo is may not be lost or will not be sink with the ship or it will not damage. So he will have an insurable interest to cargo owner. Then a creditor who has advanced the money on the security of the ship. So a person who has given the money for the security of the ship or the cargo has an insurable interest in the extent of his loan. So he is more interested also. Sir, one person died. Yenta mandi chinante procession. Idi saugu. Inti daggar nundi aa smashana poye varu kuda inka mandi line lane unnaru ante procession lane unnaru anta mandi chindi. So pakkuna adugutadu emi adugutadani ee anta pedda goppa ayana ani adugutadu. Inta mandi chindi. Samadhanam em cheptadu ఎరవడు చెప్పాల ఎస్
సరే ఇన్సూరెన్స్ బాగా చేయించుంటాడు సార్
అప్పులో అందరు అందరు వచ్చిన వాళ్ళందరు ఎవరు
డెటర్స్
క్రెడిట్ ఇచ్చిన వాళ్ళు క్రెడిట్ కార్డ్స్ డెటర్స్ కాదు చచ్చిపోయినాడు డెటర్ వచ్చిన వాళ్ళందరూ
క్రెడిటర్స్
ద క్రెడిటర్స్ హూ హాస్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ మనీ అందరు క్రెడిటర్స్ వచ్చిండు ఎందుకు వీడి దగ్గర చచ్చిపోయిండ యాక్టింగ్ చేస్తాడ కాబట్టి పాత పెట్టే వరకు ఆ కాల్చినంత వరకు అక్కడనే ఉంటారు వాళ్ళు హరి ఫలం దే వాంట్ టు సీ విత్ దేర్ ఓన్ ఐస్ సో ఎ క్రెడిటర్ హూ హాస్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ మనీ ఆర్ ఆన్ ద సెక్యూరిటీ ఆఫ్ ది షిప్ ఎవడైతే షిప్ కి అడ్వాన్స్ ఇస్తాడో ఆర్ కార్గోకు అడ్వాన్స్ ఇస్తాడో ఆర్ కార్గో ఎవరైతే అవుతుందో దట్ విల్ ఆల్సో హావింగ్ ద ఇన్సరబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఇన్ ద షిప్ షుడ్ బి సేఫ్ అండ్ ద కార్గో షుడ్ బి సేఫ్ ద మాస్టర్ అండ్ ద క్రూ ఈ మాస్టర్ కూడా అగైన్ అండ్ ద క్రూ ఆఫ్ ది షిప్ హ్యాస్ ద ఇన్సరబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఇన్ రెస్పెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ దర్ వేజెస్ సో వాళ్ళు కూడా దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద పీపుల్ దోస్ ఆర్ హావింగ్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ మ్యాటర్ వుడ్ బి దేర్ విత్ ద ఇన్సరబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఇఫ్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ మ్యాటర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇన్సూరెన్స్ ఈస్ మోటర్ గేజ్ ద మోటర్ గేజర్ has an insurable interest in the full value thereof. And the mortgagee has an insurable interest in respect of any sum due to him. Iddaru kuda interest untadandi mortgagee ki. Enduku mortgagee emo property padu gaakunta mortgagee loan ichindi adi tiri raavala kadandi.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So both they have the interest, when the subject matter is mortgage. The trustee holding any property interest has an insolvency in such a property. The trust law would have an insolvency interest in the evidence of the beneficiary with the interest in the trust. నడిపే వాళ్ళకి మాత్రం డెఫినెట్లీ దే డూ హ్యావ్ ఇట్ ద రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ ఆన్ దెమ్. ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ ది అడ్వాన్స్ ఫ్రైట్ ఆఫ్ ద పర్సన్ అడ్వాన్సింగ్ ద ఫ్రైట్ హ్యాస్ అన్ ఇన్సోబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్. ఎవరైతే ఫ్రైట్ కొరకు పైసలు ఇచ్చిందో అడ్వాన్స్ ఇచ్చిందో వాడు కూడా ఇన్సోబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఉంటుంది. ఎందుకంటే ద గూడ్ షుడ్ బి రీచ్ టు డెస్టినేషన్ సేఫ్లీ. ద ఇన్సూర్డ్ హ్యాస్ అన్ ఇన్సోబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఇన్ ద చార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇన్సూరెన్స్ పాలసీ విచ్ హీ మే టేక్. అయితే ఇన్సూర్డ్ హ్యాస్ అన్ ఇన్సోబుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఏముంటుంది? Because he wants to purchase the policy, then he will be sleeping bindas. So that is the interest he is having to have a deep sigh and a deep sleep. And a principle of indemnity, that's another principle. It means whatever the damage is caused to the subject matter, that will be indemnified by the? Yes?
Insurer.
Insurer. And insurer is the second party. The most kind of insurance policy other than the life and personal accident insurance are contract of indemnity, because life insurance and the insurance of the accident insurance will not come under the indemnity because we cannot measure the life in terms of the money. So that is the way we'll say the life insurance and the accident insurance are contracts of the indemnity, they are not. So other than this, yes, there is an indemnity fight. The insurer will take to indemnify the insured for the actual loss suffered by him as a result of the occurring of the event insured against a contract of marine. So, an insurance is an agreement whereby the insurer undertakes to indemnify the insured to the extent agreed upon. Where agreed upon? There is a deed. The deed is called bond. Our deed is called certificate. Yes. Although the insured is to be placed in the same position as if a loss has not occurred. As if the incident did not occur over there and bring back to the original position, that is the reason they have been indemnified. Injury or loss sustained by the insured has to be proved. Of course, the injury should be proved over there. Indemnity is limited to the amount specified in the policy. Suppose if you made the policy for the 1 lakh, you cannot get the more than 1 lakh, except when you buy the new another policy at the time the rebate will be given to you. The insured is indemnified only for the proximate cause. Yes. There should be a proximate cause should be there. అదే చెప్పాను కదా దొంగలు పెట్టిన 6 నెలలకు కుక్కలు మరిగినాయి అంటారు. అంటే దాంట్లో ప్రాక్సిమేట్ కాజ్ లేదు అన్నట్టు. ఇజ్ ఇట్?
Yes, sir.
The market value of the property determines the amount of indemnity. So the market value will be taken into consideration. మనం ఇలా రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ చెప్పినప్పుడు మార్కెట్ వాల్యూ ఒకటి ఉంటుంది, మనం ఇచ్చే వాల్యూ ఒకటి ఉంటుంది. అది ఫాలోయింగ్
సార్.
ఎస్. అంటే మరి ఇది ఏది ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది, మార్కెట్ వాల్యూ ఎక్కువ ఉంటుందా, ఇచ్చే పైసలు ఎక్కువ?
సార్ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ది వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ ది మార్కెట్ వాల్యూ సార్.
మార్కెట్ వాల్యూ ప్రకారమే మీరు రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ ఫీ కడతారు అక్కడ స్టాంప్ డ్యూటీ. ఇస్ ఇట్ ఆర్ నాట్?
ఎస్ సార్. ఎట్ ద టైమ్ వెన్ ద క్లెయిమ్ ఈస్ డన్ ఎట్ ద టైమ్ ద మార్కెట్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ లెస్ సార్, దెన్ యూ విల్ గెట్ ఓన్లీ that amount. But if the market value is more, the according to the indemnifier, according to the indemnity, the agreed value will be paid and remaining amount will be collected from remaining amount will not be collected, sir.
ఇప్పుడు మనం రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ చేపించుకుంటున్నాం ఇల్లు. అయితే మనము బ్యాంక్ డీడీలో బ్యాంక్ డ్రాఫ్ట్ లో ఏవో ఇస్తాం. ఎక్కడ ఇస్తాం? రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫీస్ లో ఇస్తాం. అదేనా అమౌంట్? లేకుంటే మరి మళ్ళీ వేరే విధంగా క్యాష్ కూడా తీసుకుంటారా? అవునా?
రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ దేనికి సార్?
హౌస్ రిజిస్ట్రేషన్.
ఎస్ సార్.
చెప్పండి.
అప్పుడు తీసుకుంటారు సార్, అంతే అది.
దట్ మీన్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ది చెక్స్ విచ్ యూ హావ్ గివెన్ ఇన్ ద రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ దట్ ఓన్లీ ద వర్త్ ఆఫ్ ది బిల్డింగ్. కానీ they take in the form of the check or DD in the registration, but they also take cash separately, because for reducing the stamp duty they make the market value, which the registration department will fix. As per that one, but actually the cost of it is more. And you have to make the difference in the form of a cash, but for the registration purpose, the practicality is there to show to the bank is the check forms. My point is, actual practice is different and practical is different. That's my point, not one. So next principle is the principle of subrogation. As I told you that the insurer will step into the shoe of the insured and get the claim from the defaulter, and whose fault is there. That is called principle of subrogation. So in marine policy, the insurer must have paid the claim before they are entitled the right of subrogation. Whether the loss paid is total or partial, insurer subrogate to all the rights and remedies of the insured. However, the insurer can retain only up to the amount they have indemnified the insured under the subrogation. So whatever the amount which he has given in the subrogation, that only can be indemnified by the insurer. So that is the principle of subrogation. Then such rights or remedies include the right of the recovery from the third parties, and in the event of lost goods or destinations, the sum insured, which is agreed value, will be paid. In case the goods are damaged during the transit, the amount payable is arrived as a proportionate of the sum insured according to the percent of the depreciation suffered by the goods as certified by the survivors. Suppose if you have supplied the tomatoes, instead of reaching the 3 days, it took the 8 days. What will happen in it?
The goods will perish, sir.
The goods will be perished over there. So the charges will be paid by the cargo fellow because they have made the time bound. 3 days they should have reached. Kani, untoward incident in Ankondi. Then he cannot do anything. Kapo the tire first time in Ankondi. Suppose Stepney is there, the second tire that he should make. సార్ నాలుగు టైర్లు కూడా బస్ట్ అయింది అనుకోండి ఏది దారులని దెన్ దే హావ్ టు సీ దట్ ఇమీడియట్లీ గెట్ ఇట్ రిపేర్డ్ అండ్ సీ దట్ ద గూడ్స్ షుడ్ బి రీచ్డ్ ద డెస్టినేషన్ అదర్వైజ్ ద అనదర్ వెహికల్ షుడ్ బి బ్రాట్ ఓవర్ దేర్ అండ్ ద గూడ్ షుడ్ బి రీచ్డ్ ద డెస్టినేషన్ అదర్వైజ్ హెవీ లాస్ వుడ్ బి దేర్ బికాస్ బై టేకింగ్ ద టైమ్ దట్ గూడ్స్ షుడ్ బి పెరిష్ సో పెరిషబుల్ గూడ్స్ దే విల్ సీ దట్ ద క్యారియర్ ఈస్ గుడ్ కండిషన్ నెంబర్ వన్ నెంబర్ టూ దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ ద ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ అనదర్ క్యారియర్ వుడ్ బి దేర్ టు క్యారీ ఇట్ వెన్ సచ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ హ్యాపెన్ Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
If the bus is not full, then there will be a bus or two buses spare. Let me tell you. If you are going to, if the bus failure is there, then immediately this bus will go.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. And then the conclusion that we will see that in marine insurance that we will write it up, and the marine insurance is the mechanism that helps to mitigate the risk of the financial loss to the property, such as a ship. అయితే షిప్ కానీ కానీ యాక్సెసరీస్ అని కానివ్వండి గూడ్స్ కన్నా కానివ్వండి ఓవెయిట్ కన్నా కానివ్వండి ఫ్లోటింగ్ పాలసీస్ అన్నా కానివ్వండి ఆర్ టైం బౌండ్ అన్నా కానివ్వండి ఇన్ ఎనీ అదర్ మోడ్ ఇన్ మెరైన్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ ఆన్ ద పేమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రీమియం బై ద ఇష్యూ టు ద ఇన్సూరర్ సో ఇన్సూరర్ ప్రొవైడ్ ద రిస్క్ కవర్ ద షిప్ ఓనర్ ఆర్ ద కార్గో ఓనర్ ఆర్ అగేన్స్ ద లాస్ ఆర్ డ్యామేజ్ ఆర్ ద షిప్ ఆర్ ద కార్గో మే సఫర్ ఇన్ ట్రాన్సిట్ డ్యూ టు ద యాక్సిడెంట్ ఆర్ మిషర్స్ ఇన్ ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫైనాన్షియల్ ఇండెమినిటీ will be made by the insured. The insurance company undertakes to make good the loss to the maximum value as agreed with the insured for perils and risks. Loss is payable only when it has been proximately caused by the insured peril. So the proximate cause should be there for such a loss. The marine insurance is governed by the national legal regimes. In India, Marine Insurance Act 1963 regulates the various aspects of marine insurance. So this is the actually the how the marine insurance will make it out, and however the fact that the divergent national legal regimes exist in the conduct of the marine insurance policies has in certain consequence of for the parties to contract, particularly the assured, who will have the difficulty in understanding the coverage of the foreign insurance market without the informality in the national marine insurance legal regime. The international conduct of the marine insurance, particularly from the assured prospective, would be severely impeded. But in generally, when you say that marine, when you want to sell the goods, what I heard from the people, the Japanese ship, their luggage charges is very less. And what I heard is, But I don't know whether it is true or not, because it is a very big vessel. It carries a lot of weight. That's why it goes from, and the speed also very good. And the people prefer it, and preferably it is because of the ship construction, the ship model, and ship the engine capacity, and it is safety. So based on that thing, they make it out. And most of the cargo would be on water through the ships will be made, and that is Japan, which will charge the lesser cargo freight charges, and the safety to reach the place also an important factor. And these are the things which will come into the picture. And the cargo is mostly transferred, heavy cargo, through the on the sail only, voyage only, not by the freight. Not in the form of a flight, that is the air, or not by a road. So these are the things which are covered under the marine insurance. And then now the time still you have it, but I would like to close it. And tomorrow we'll see what we want to make it out. Because if you happen to see the question paper, you will see that what would be the next will come insurance. Yes, it is here. Then question paper. Yes, if you just type Q, you will get a question paper LIA. Yes, it is open. So these are the things. Explain the growth and development of the insurance business in India. That is also one of the. Explain the growth, and we are going the reverse order. So let us say liabilities of the insurer. We did what are the life insurance contract. Explain them. Define insurance. Distinguish between a contract of insurance and contingent plan. Let us see that in the tomorrow class, explain the growth and development of the insurance. Yes, this is the insurance. Yeah, insurance in India. Explain the growth and development of the insurance business in India. So how the development, the insurance business growth in India, that we will see in the tomorrow class. And of course, we are make the repetition, and our class is based on the questions. And if you have any other questions in advance, if you make it out to me, then we will discuss that thing more on that aspect. With this, that I would like to take your leave. And before going, that I would like to say thank you very much for your patient listening. And here, thank slide also put it over there. And with this, I would like to stop my today class. Have a good day and goodbye. The next class is the development of the marine insurance business.